croc game.
Ooh, what's that? Is that Powerade? No, that ain't Powerade.
You can drink it if you want, though.
You for real? No. Oh, no. What do we got, Kevin?
So pretty much what we're going to do today is, well, the main issue that I'm having with this thing is that she started to stays on a bit. She won't go into gear while the motor's running.
Oh, shit.
I bled the clutch before, but maybe I didn't do it right. Yeah. Maybe, you know, while the thing's running, the clutch can't really compress the flywheel or the clutch or whatever, you know, to switch gears. So I'm going to try to bleed it again. Last time I had to do it by myself using the bottle method like this. So I'm going to try that again. And hopefully it works this time.
Hopefully. Turn up. What's that you doing there, Kevin?
Trying to break, well, not break, but open up this clutch line. More
really?
Likely it's this, probably.
Move your hand real quick.
See, it's this little nip thing.
All right. What's the bottle for?
Pretty much to catch the fluid.
Oh, for real?
Yep.
I always thought it was something to drink. I mean, Powerade did come out with a new flavor, right?
Yeah, I mean, you could, Mountain Dew, dude, you can drink this.
Oh, yeah, huh? Melomania, ayy. Shout out to Mountain Dew. That was a pretty fire flavor, if you ask me.
I haven't tried it yet.
I totally recommend it.
There you go.
All right. Oh, so you got it plugged up right there. And so it's basically serving as a catch can.
Yeah. Catch the air and stuff.
Yeah. All right. So the goal now is to freaking... Ooh, the Air Maxes. And the goal now is to pretty much bleed the line.
Yeah, you want to make sure this stays full.
This, dot three.
No, not this.
Oh.
This there.
That, oh, my bad.
Yeah, you want to make sure that stays full. So I'm going to pump the clutch. And you'll see the air bubbles coming out of the, out from underneath.
From underneath?
Yeah.
Okay, hold up there. Ooh, painstaking process.
Coming up.
Yeah, it's coming out.
See the air bubbles?
Yeah. Hella air bubbles, if you ask me. Tell the people why you do not want air bubbles in the system. Your clutch won't get compressed right, and what else?
Well, I'm refilling this.
Oh, okay.
I gotta keep making sure this is full.
You're using dot three, Kevin, on bleeding the clutch.
Yeah, that's what you use for the clutch. This one specifically dot three, and the majority of them are dot three.
Yeah, it's not just being used as a brake fluid, correct?
Yeah. Pretty much, you know.
Hey, wee. What's the process you're doing right now?
Just tying it back up so I can press the clutch up there.
Right now, he is pressing the clutch. And you see how the fluid is going down just a bit?
Refill it if it's going down too much.
Yeah, I got you. So far, it's maintaining. I mean, if I zoom in, it's like...
How low is it?
It's not really that low, bro.
And without it being on the ground...
Where's the impact?
There it goes.
Where's the impact from?
Harbor Freight? Harbor Freight Special.
Sheesh.
I don't expect it to last that long.
Yeah. Can you tell the audience why are you taking off the wheel?
Just so my fat ass can fit under there a lot better.
Damn, nah, you ain't fat, bro. You just dummy thick.
Thick, with two C's. Yeah, but that's not too bad, bro. You know, these lug nuts have been on there for like a year or so, you know?
For real, dude.
And I didn't loosen them up. I just jacked up the car. They were like, probably be a good idea to take the wheel off.
Still up in the air and shit.
then overheat or get leave that burn smell. So not bad so far.
Not bad for an earthquake.
Yeah. I wish it was Milwaukee, but
Milwaukee is a badass brand too.
It is. I love Milwaukee. But fuck it.
Alright, so now that he has taken off the wheel, his thick self can have plenty of room.
Now I'm going back under there to loosen the line up again.
Yeah.
And get the air bubbles out, then tighten and repeat pretty much.
Yeah.
A lot better.
What's that song? I live in a land down under.
Yeah, the one.
Little sneak peek of the inside, a little before.
Pretty sure they're like squirrels living in there.
It's squirrels,
oh yeah, shit. Look at my bucket seat, bro. They're like nuts.
Oh my god. Okay, but what we're about to do now is we're gonna bleed the clutch again, you say?
Yeah, you gotta get all the air bubbles out of it.
Oh, okay.
So you gotta pump it like just three times, and on the fourth time, hold it down.
Yeah, all right.
And don't let it off, I'll tell you.
I got you. So, one, two, three, four, holding.
Okay, let it off again.
Let off. Sponsored by Croc Gang.
I don't step on it. I need to loosen it a little bit more.
All right. What are you noticing down there?
A lot of air coming out.
Oh shit. All right, Kevin. So after a couple of trials and errors, what did the final trial do to us?
I don't know. It feels the same. But... hold up. I'll show you what I mean. Alright, we'll try.
Show me.
Get it in here real quick.
Or show us.
Oh my god.
What dummy thing? Sheesh!
Alright. So, if you check out the clutch now,
it kicks back up.
It does have that little top end play. See?
Yeah.
I don't know if that's normal or not. And I, second time I bleed it. So, clutch down. First, second, third, fourth,
fifth,
and reverses.
Reverse. But where's a six at? Or it's only a five speed.
No, you're right. That's reverse way.
No, wait, hold on.
Oh, yeah.
Start over again.
First. Second. Third. Fourth. Fifth.
Six. There you go. Reverse.
Maybe. I don't know. I'm still...
could be.
So if we're like, possibly...
Oh, well, there's neutral. Always Google to help us out on the pattern.
Yeah, I mean, I'll figure it out eventually when I try.
Yeah.
I slam it in six and I hit money shot.
Yeah.
We'll find out on track or something.
I hope so. Okay.
This was a successful bleed out, was it?
I mean...
to us or to you at least?
It's the same. It feels the same way like I bled it the first time.
Yeah.
But who knows? Now, but you guys see now that like... when the motor ain't running, it goes in gear. Smooth, all good.
Yeah, like butter.
Yeah, so I'm about to get the battery, plug it up. You guys gonna hear it start up.
Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa! Whoa!
What?
It's gonna be loud as fuck.
Oh my god, you got me freaking stoked.
What's that thing you say? Turn the fuck up?
Turn the fuck up. Well, y'all, this is what y'all been waiting for. This is the moment of truth. Hit it, Kevin. Any minute now. Any second now.
1 second,
T. Damn, I was really hyping that up.
Oh, am I doing it?
No, it's too late now. Okay. Just go. Bro.
Okay, it's happening. Everybody stay calm. What's the procedure, everyone? What's the procedure?
Stay
that was for everybody that doubted my boy right here that couldn't, that said the S14 wouldn't be running. Sheesh, what do you have to say to them, Kevin?
I love them.
Hey.
I
love
them. I doubted myself, so.
No, I mean, yeah, dude. I mean, at times, it happens, you know what I mean? But yeah. that's when you shine the brightest.
The only thing is that first time I blew the clutch and everything like that, it only going first, and I could only move it forward, you know?
Yeah.
This time that I bled it, now while the motor's running, now going first, second, third, fourth. But at the beginning, it did go in reverse. Right now, it won't go in reverse, you know? It won't go in fifth, and it won't go in sixth or reverse.
Oh, okay, so...
So I'm assuming I'm going to have to
bleed it again.
Yeah, bleed it one more time.
Yeah.
You know? Back then, I only had one gear. That was first.
Yeah.
Now, I got like three of them, or four of them. So it's a step in the right direction, I guess.
Oh, yeah, for sure, man. Shit. I'm
missing three more.
So yes sir, right now we just gotta bleed it again, and then hopefully the next video will be more exciting than this.
Yeah,
or at least for S14 content.
Yeah, just a couple more things too, like I still need a reservoir tank right here to plug up. Shorter one of these, because you see how the thing wraps up around.
Yeah, look at
so
that.
I need a shorter one of these positive terminal cables. I gotta mess with my Dakota Digital, that way that the RPMs from the 5.3 can match up with the S14's dash.
You don't say.
Yeah, so I've been trying to get to that, bro, and I got so much shit going on. I mean, I finally got the truck going though.
Hey,
yeah, we just
got the freaking LS1 from a junkyard, didn't we?
Yeah, exactly, you know, so it's all good.
Yeah, man, shit.
This one now got now she can move. Just can't reverse or go into fifth.
Baby steps. Baby steps at a time right now.
Yeah, once I bleed it again, then she'll be all right after that. It's baby stuff and she's back on the road.
For sure. Sheesh.
The main thing is finding time to work on it.
Yeah, I know, dude, because we pretty much have like opposite schedules and whatnot.
Yeah, that's the only thing. But on that, you know, good shit.
Good shit.
And she moved maybe a good foot.
Nah, I say like 6 inches. No, not even say 6 inches.
Nah, good point. This was under.
Oh, shit, yeah, huh? Look.
Yeah, she moved at least a foot.
You see how it's flat in that area right there? Oh, damn.
Yeah, so she moved a good bit.
All right. Well, appreciate the views, y'all. I hope y'all keep hitting that like button and the subscribe button. Stay tuned in for the next video. And, yeah, appreciate it, y'all.
Yeah.